Good afternoon. Thank you for joining today's Google Hangout hosted by the U.S. Department of State. My name is Jessica Klein, and I'm glad to be able to discuss the U.S. government's commitments to aid transparency and to demonstrate our newly redesigned ForeignAssistance.gov. Foreign assistance is aid given by the United States to other countries to support global peace, security, and development efforts, and provide humanitarian relief during times of crisis. About 1% of the federal budget goes to support foreign assistance programs in more than 100 countries around the world through the efforts of over 20 different U.S. government agencies. These investments further America's foreign policy interests on issues ranging from expanding free markets, combating extremism, ensuring stable democracies, and addressing the root causes of poverty, while simultaneously fostering global goodwill. A key focus of our development efforts is working to promote transparent and accountable governments around the world. We believe that transparency and accountability are fundamental elements of good governance. Because we believe this, it increases our responsibility to ensure that we embody these beliefs here in Washington. ForeignAssistance.gov is the U.S. government's main tool for improving foreign aid transparency. Transparency and open data enable the public to better understand U.S. aid investments around the world, to make foreign aid more useful for development, and to help hold ourselves more accountable. Since its launch in 2010, ForeignAssistance.gov has been working to establish standard aid reporting requirements across the government, support agencies in quarterly data reporting, and develop a dynamic and user-friendly website. Its mission is to serve as a central repository where stakeholders can easily access and use foreign assistance budget, financial, and award information in a standardized and easy-to-understand format. ForeignAssistance.gov reporting requirements include all international data fields from the International Aid Transparency Initiative, IATI, all data fields required for domestic reporting to Congress, and other key data elements. Currently, on ForeignAssistance.gov, you will find data from 10 agencies that represent about 98% of the U.S. government's foreign aid portfolio, and over $30 billion annually. Additionally, tens of thousands of financial records are available to the public and updated on a quarterly basis. Some of the largest assistance contributors are the U.S. Department of State, the U.S. Agency for International Development, and the Millennium Challenge Corporation. We recently redesigned ForeignAssistance.gov to provide users with a simplified and more user-friendly experience. The redesign is a result of a year-long effort working with stakeholders, the public, and data users to improve the website. So now I'm going to demonstrate some of the key features of the newly designed website. I will show you how to download the data to do your own analysis, explore information, and gather high-level statistics on countries, sectors, or agencies, and to search within the data. Okay, so here's the homepage of ForeignAssistance.gov. This menu bar gives you access from any page on the site to the main features: visual exploration, text search, instant download, or learning materials. Scrolling down the homepage, you'll see another way to access the map or search the data. You'll also find a brief overview of the history of U.S. foreign assistance, and then you'll find overviews of the three primary groupings of the data: by country, by sector, and by agency. So I'll start with the primary way of exploring the data visually, which is through this heat map. This is a heat map of the world, and it allows you to do some additional drill downs through this map on the left, or through this toolbar on the left. You can toggle between the three main stages of foreign assistance funding, which is planning or budgeting, obligating, and disbursements or expenditures. So here the heat map will change as I change my selection. You can also sort by categories and agencies. So if I'm interested, for example, in health, I can click on health. I'll see the change on the heat map, and then you can further drill down. For example, here's maternal and child health or malaria. You can also toggle by year and by agency. If there's a country you would like to explore in more depth, you click on the country, you select the country, And then over here, you would click View Kenya Data. Here, you'll find more details specific to that country. So here we have a brief narrative on activities happening in Kenya. You can have quick and easy access to download the full set of Kenya data and some basic World Bank statistics. Scrolling down a little bit further, you can start to dig into the data again by the main funding types, planned, obligated, or spent, on a yearly basis, on a category or agency basis. So for example, if I'm interested in planning data for Kenya for 2015, here I can see that most of the planning data, budgeting data, is for health. I can select health and further dive down to see that most of that health money is made up of HIV/AIDS, followed by malaria and family planning. Further drilling down shows which agencies are planning on those funds. I can scroll up a little bit, change this to obligated, update the data results, and here I can see that obligations for the year 2015, mostly made in health, which would make sense, HIV/AIDS again, and scrolling down, I can see that USAID, HHS, and Peace Corps are all contributing to this data. You can also search on an agency basis, planning data, obligated and spent. So update the data results to see the agency information for Kenya. Another way to explore the data is by agency. So here we have all of the 10 agencies currently reporting to FA.gov. I'll select USAID to learn more about that agency's work and get a brief overview. Again, you have instant access to all of USAID's data, some quick links to other important foreign assistance sites that agency might own, and the ability to drill down again against the three planning types, budgeting, obligating, and disbursements. And here you have every transaction record available. So this information includes information on the partner organizations implementing the foreign aid program. You have the ability to select data elements or filter data elements. And then those will pop up down here where you can download these selected elements or you can deselect them to remove. A third way to visually explore the information is by sector. So sectors provide an understanding of the purpose of the activity. For example, agriculture, basic education, and civil society are three of the possible sector assignments. And these sectors are organized under 9 broader categories. So for example, I'll select health. And again, we have an overview page of this category, access to download all of the health data, and all of the transactions, all the financial records that would be about health. And you can further reduce this information. We have over 68,000 records here by sector or by country. Okay. Another way to find information is through the search function. So this allows for free text searching. So I could search for HIV, click on get results. It recommends actually that I visit the health category page, and then it brings up over 33,000 data results, which this can be further filtered. Again, you can select certain transactions here, and they'll be brought up at the bottom where you can download. Another example would be searching by country. I'll search for Kenya. Again, it brings up a recommended page result, and it brings up almost 7,000 data results. You can search for other terms that you might find. For example, if you're interested in trafficking in persons information, there are 0 page results because we don't have a sector for the specific issue, but there are almost 1,000 data results where the word trafficking is involved somewhere in this record. Finally, you could search by implementer names. So for example, I'll do Chemonix, which is a large implementing partner we work with. And here, again, no page results because we don't have a page specific to them, but we have over 2,000 data results. And you can see what kinds of programs and in what countries and with what agencies that organization is working with. Okay. So those are ways to download the data, but there is also instant download access from any page by hovering over the download menu bar, where you can download the entire set of data housed on ForeignAssistance.gov, or you can reduce it by country, by agency, or by account. Finally, this Learn menu bar provides background materials to help users understand the data, some of our aid transparency goals, the US budgeting process, IADI, and other information. So I encourage you to look at this material to understand the data available on the website, especially the FAQs. We have a large number of FAQs that we've answered over the years based on questions from the public and other users. So this is a great source of information. So if you have questions, recommend you take a look there. We have also tried to explain more about the data that's housed on ForeignAssistance.gov, IADI, which is the International Aid Transparency Initiative, and its relationship to ForeignAssistance.gov and the federal budget process. If these learning materials don't answer all of your questions, we have a Contact Us feature on the website where we gladly welcome questions, comments, any questions you might have. We'll get back to you in just a few business days if you leave an email, which is not required. But if you leave one, we will answer any questions you have. So that's the quick overview of ForeignAssistance.gov. I would be glad to take any questions that you might have. And again, if you don't have questions now, but you take a look at the site and realize you have some, please contact us through the mechanism on the website. Okay, so it doesn't look like we have any questions. Thank you for participating in today's Google Hangout. I hope it was informative, and I hope you take the chance to look at ForeignAssistance.gov, and please do send us questions if you have any. Thank you.